Hey guys, thanks for joining us here.
Hi everybody.
Shabbat Shalom, everyone. Here we are. Welcome to our home. You're visiting us here in Atlantic Highlands, and we're about a half a mile from the bay, about 2 miles from the ocean, and this is where we are. We're just here to celebrate some music with you tonight and celebrate a wonderful Shabbat, even though things are strange and crazy in the world since maybe the last time we had a concert. But what we want to do is just focus our hearts and our minds and share with you some songs that mean a lot to us. Hopefully they'll mean a lot to you as well. Aly and I'd love to sing together. We love to do worship. Yes. We love ministry. But we love to write songs and sing the songs we've written. And we got used to doing this pretty regularly when we were fresh out of Nashville, Tennessee. You know, some of you know we moved from Nashville, Tennessee to the Jersey Shore in 2006, and we were songwriters there. And when we got here, we needed a place to play, so living on Main Street in Ocean Grove, we found a home at the local cafe every Friday night, and we would start off singing this song. It was requested by Jesse Clark, our number one fan,
Jesse,
for 9 years. And you'll know exactly what this is, Jesse. This is In Your Love. Nothing moves me, nothing shakes the earth beneath me like your love, your never-ending love. And nothing soothes me, nothing makes my hardships easy like your love, your never-changing love. My spirit prays to know the of love, of love. Wherever I go, I'll only go in your love. And whatever I do, I'll only do in your love, only in your love. Sometimes love is like a mighty waterfall, or ocean wave comes crashing to the ground. Other times your love is not like that at all. It's gentle rain, it doesn't make a sound. Sometimes it's tears that promise years of love, of love. Wherever I go, I'll only go in your love. And whatever I do, I'll only do in your love, only in your love. Though I lose patience, your love prevails. In tribulations, love never fails. Wherever I go, I only go in your love. And whatever I do, I'll only do wherever I go, I'll only go in your love. Whatever I do, I'll only do in your love, only in your love, only in your love. Yeah. How about that for a start on a Friday night? Well, we're just getting started here on this Friday night. I hope that you're having a good time. I hope that you're with someone you love. And if you're not, if you're all alone with just a computer screen, we love you. We love you. We're glad that you're here. So you are with someone you love. So what we're going to do is just some songs from our CDs. Aly and I recorded tons of CDs. That's because we know that they're all in boxes in our garage. We know how much they weigh. It's tons, believe me. Welcome to them if you want to come by and get them. Where are we going to go?
Let it go.
Okay, this is, as you can tell, a little bit of a country flair of a song I wrote while I was here in New Jersey, but then I brought it right to Nashville, recorded it there. While we were there, I was there, I met up with some other songwriters, and it was the summer of 1994. It was the summer of 1994. It was the 25th anniversary of Woodstock. So me and another long-haired songwriter went up to Woodstock, and we kind of just hung around until we got invited backstage, and we were able to, for the 25th anniversary of the Woodstock Festival, able to play some songs between acts, and this is one of them. It's called Let It Go. There's a feeling in the air, the spirit's moving everywhere. With love I can't conceal, I feel the way I used to feel, a feeling I want you to share. I know you wanna jump right in, you're not sure where to begin. And I know you understand, you just got to reach out your hand. You're still holding back within. Seems like you're holding on to nothing, and you don't want to let go. Went out chasing after something, and now you're empty and alone. You traded everything for and now there's nothing left to show. You're holding on to nothing. let it go, let it go, let it go. I've seen sparks turn into flames, and I've seen healing in His name. And there's forgiveness here, the darkness seems to disappear. I wish that you could feel the same, but deep inside I know you know. Just let the hope inside you grow. But you cannot break free until you give up willingly, letting everything else go. When it feels like you're holding on to nothing, chasing after something, and now you're empty and alone. Traded everything for nothing, and now there's nothing left to show. You're holding on to nothing. Let it go. Let it go. It's like you're holding on to nothing. Let it go, let it go, let it go. All right, guys. Well, we're off to a good start. We're glad that you're here. And while you're here, why don't you comment and let us know that you're here? We have a couple of our staff manning the computers, and I'm doing the microphone stand. It's slipping slowly as I sing.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. There we go. But we'd like to know that you're here. We'll comment back right at you later when we review our show and our comments. We're just glad that you came by. And listen, I know it's tough times out there, and we all need a little encouragement. We are here to encourage. Our family's very encouraged. We're healthy. We're praying for those that are not healthy. We believe that this thing's going to end soon, and even when it does, we're going to stay as a shelter-in-place type family for as many nights as we can, because we're enjoying having a great time with each other, playing games, singing songs, writing songs, having worship services right from our living room.
Yes, we are.
North Shore Fellowship. So we're staying encouraged. What do you want to do? Let's
do we can do. You want to do It's Your Love?
Yeah.
All right.
I love that song. Tell us about it.
All right. Well. Many years ago, I was in a band called the Rock Flowers, and while I was in that band, I wrote this song called It's Your Love, and it got a little bit of excitement in the Nashville scene.
A little bit. It won the national award.
Yeah, it did. It, we actually won the Gospel Music Association 2002 Band of the Year. Well, it wasn't. We really weren't the band of the year, but we were like a regional band of the year. It was something. But anyway, it's called It's Your Love.
It's your love.
Oh, the is calling to your faith and hope and love. Sometimes it's disappointing when I see what I'm made of. You say love always believes all things, and love hopes and perseveres. And you say that when perfection comes, the imperfect disappears. And it's
love, it's your love, it's your love, it's your love. It's your love, it's your love, it's your love.
Give me what I need to believe in your promises that you will intercede for me, and give me love to love you with, and the faith to believe in you, and the hope that I can hold to believe you will come through with your
love. It's your love, it's your love, it's your love.
Yeah, it's a lot. We have two people clap after each song, which is very much like our normal.
And like a bunch of Beanie Boos, actually, too. We've got
we have a concert.
A little audience on the couch.
Bright eyes staring at us from the seats.
Hello.
Okay, well, we want to just do some of these songs because they mean a lot to us. Each one of them that we write a song, it's like not just we feel like we came up with a good melody and some catchy lyrics, but it's usually something that we're going through, and we write a song as a reminder of the truth we found when we were going through it, and that's how we dig back and get inspired, re-inspired by our songs. What song do we want next?
How about Jamie?
This is not an inspiring song by any means. Depressing song, no. Well, it's a song that if you know the song, you know that it's about a boy and a train. I wrote this as I was sitting on my back porch in Nashville, Tennessee. Thinking about what should I write? What kind of song should I write? I wanted to write a country song. And country songs, they say it's three chords and the truth. I was looking for a little story. I was looking for something I can share. A story, something happens, some kind of trouble, some type. Anyway, as I'm thinking about what to write about, way out in the distance, I hear a train go by, way out in the woods. I couldn't see the train. And I thought about trains when I was a little kid. We didn't have one close to our house, but a couple miles away in New Brunswick, we'd ride our bikes. And when we got there, the Metroliner that went to New Brunswick, to New York, the Jersey Transit, would zoom by every once in a while. So what we did is what all the kids did. We'd put little pieces of metal on top of the tracks, nickels, dimes, safety pins, paper clips, whatever we could find. And somehow the flat top of the rail, train would go by and we'd find our pieces later and they'd be flat as a guitar pick, really. Flat as a razor sometimes. That was our idea of fun. And I thought maybe way out in the Tennessee hills, there's a boy that did the same thing for fun. And maybe his name was Jamie. And maybe he has an interesting story. So I wrote this song. It's about a boy and a train. It's about much deeper than that. If you really look at it, listen to it, contemplate it. And if you're a heavy, deep thinking person, it's much more than just a boy and a train. I'm not one of you. For me, it's just a boy and train song. Jamie. Jamie was a 10-year-old with big blue eyes and hair of gold. He lived along the railroad tracks and he played beneath the bridge. He never cared for balls and bikes, for fishing poles and Boy Scout hikes, just skipping stones and listening for the train along the ridge. You could feel the rumble way before you hear the whistle blow. You could hear the whistle blow before you see the train. You can count the boxcars as the steel wheels race along the rails, and when it's gone, the diesel fumes are all that will remain. Jamie had a wooden box he hid among the river rocks, and in it he kept all his flattened treasures as his prize. Pennies that were paper thin, and nickels and dimes and safety pins, and many parts and pieces you could barely recognize. You could feel the rumble way before you hear the whistle blow. You can hear the whistle blow before you see the train. You can count the boxcars as the steel wheels race along the rails, and when it's gone, the diesel fumes are all that will remain. Whoa, 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 first day the CSX came past, it was twice as big and twice as fast. It barely made a rumble and it hardly made a sound. And even to this day I'm told they never found the 10-year-old. A shattered box of flattened metal things was all they found. But they say that somewhere out there Jamie's saying, you can feel the rumble way before you hear the whistle blow. You can hear the whistle blow before you see the train. You can count the boxcars as the steel wheels race along the rails, and when it's gone, the diesel fumes are all that will remain. And I'll ask you now, can you feel the rumble way before you hear the whistle blow? And can you hear the whistle blow before you ever see the train? Can you count the boxcars as the steel wheels race along the rails? When it's gone, the diesel fumes are all that will remain. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Whistle.
I never knew what that was, but every time I did it,
it sounds, yeah, like a train whistle.
Is it a whistle, or is it like a bell on the caboose? I don't even know what that is. But yeah,
I don't know, but it sounds like it fits, so perfect.
All right, Allie's calling the shots, so she tells me what to do. She's the woman of the house, and guys, let me tell you something. Happy wife, happy life. Let them call the shots.
True.
Tell you what songs to play.
Very true,
everything
very
goes
true.
Smooth. All right, what songs?
All right, so are you ready to do maybe Worry? Time Will Tell, Worry?
Yeah, we could do that.
Okay, let's switch guitars.
All right, so I'm going to switch guitars real quick. So I'm going from my Olsen to my Gibson. We could talk about guitars all night. I don't know if that's what we're here for, though. But we will mention some special guitars that I'll be playing tonight. I'm home, so I brought my collection of guitars. All right.
Uh-oh.
Better. You hearing it? Yeah.
That's better.
All right, so what song is it?
I think we're going to start with Worry.
Okay. I think I posted this recently. It's a song about worrying. It's a song about what it means when you're tossing and turning all night. And you just can't find peace of mind and what it is we're supposed to do. Last night I couldn't sleep, I lied awake and tried to keep from worrying about the days and weeks ahead. And as I tossed and turned all night, I closed my eyes and tried to fight the restless, nervous feeling in my head. But your hand is strong, your words are true, and I just gotta trust them. That's all I've got to do. When anxious worry finds me, your precious word reminds me, worrying won't add a single day. At times I'm unfulfilled and forced to live by faith, but still I wouldn't have it any other way. 'Cause your hand is strong, your words are true, and I believe in you. And when I face anxiety and doubtful spirits lie to me, they say I can't believe what I can't see. I put away that fear and doubt and quit trying to figure out the questions of my self-sufficiency. Because your hand is strong, your words are true, and I just gotta trust them. That's all I've got to do. When anxious worry finds me, your precious word reminds me, worrying won't add a single day. At times I'm unfulfilled and forced to live by faith, but still I wouldn't have it any other way. 'Cause I know that there are plans that you have for me, and they're only plans for good and not calamity. And they give to me a future and a hope. When anxious worry finds me, your precious word reminds me, worrying won't add a single day. At times I'm unfulfilled and forced to live by faith, still I wouldn't have it any other way. 'Cause your hand is strong, your words are true, and I believe in you. Thank you guys.
All right.
Thank you.
Oh, I'm looking at a request from Mercy Fishman. Raphael, sing the song that you wrote for your girls.
Oh, wow. I got a request. Okay.
Yes, we'll do that. We can do that at one point.
If you guys have requests, you could pop them in there. And if we still remember them, we'll sing them. We're here all night.
Yeah.
Pop them in the comments.
It's true.
I think we're streaming this to North Shore Fellowship as well as Raphael and Aly and my personal site. So I don't know if the girls are monitoring all three, but you may want to look around. We're going to do Show Me a Sign.
Yes, so another Rockflower song. Hoping I can remember all the lyrics. She's driving, she's hiding this empty feeling once again. He's waiting while she's praying, she wants to let him in. She's reeling and she's feeling the anxious worries in her mind. She's crying, but he died and he wants to give her life. and she feels a little lost when she thinks about the past, all the love she gave to things that did not last. Then she starts to count the cost when she sees a flash of light, and it is the spark that one day will burn bright. She says,
show me,
I need to know if you are there.
Know me,
I need to know you really care.
Free me
out of this prison that is mine.
I need you
to show me a sign. She see and believe it, because he's given her new eyes. She's knowing and it's showing in every part of her life. She's living and she's giving. He promises to do his part. He's changing, rearranging everything in her heart. But she needs a little sign, or she's gonna go out of her mind. But she sees they're getting easier to find. She says,
show me,
I need to know if you are there.
Know me,
I need to know you. He gives good gifts to those who ask. She needs a faith that's gonna last. And now she's asking him to open up her eyes. Her eyes.
Behind us is that the day is turning to dusk.
It is.
And it's going to turn to evening. Behind us. If you can look a half a mile through those trees, you'd see the water. But we can't.
All right. How about healing?
Yes, let's do healing.
Let's talk about healing.
Well, my name, Raphael, is a Hebrew word. It means healing God. Healing God. Means that God heals, and he doesn't just heal diseases and sicknesses and injuries and things like that. He heals hearts as well. And I wrote this song probably oh gosh, in the early 90s, and it just wasn't finished. It was really kind of a concept of a song. And at the time, I was living next to one of my label mates, my best friend, and one of my real heroes of guitar and Christian music, Phil Keggy. And we would get together and sing songs together, write some songs together. And I brought him this song. I said, it's not really complete. It has an idea, it has some chords. So we worked on it together down in his studio and his basement, and we ended up with coming up with a finished song. We recorded it together. It's a song called Healing, and it goes out to anybody who needs healing in any way. We all need healing. Lived 250,000 hours, and I have seen 10,000 days. If you look through me, you can see my scars in my heart and in my face. Some things that you're just reactions to things done to me long ago. Though I found a way to live my life, I'm oftentimes reminded that I know that I need healing, healing. We all need healing from the things we left behind. And when the bitterness inside us melts away somehow, we'll never have to think about it now. We'll never have to think about it now. My mind is full of names and faces of people whom I tend to blame. I may feel justified to be this way, but I know it's unforgiveness just the same. Now I just want to go on from here. I want to live a life that's free. If God can heal someone who's blind or lame, I'm sure that He can do the same for me. But I need healing, I need healing. We all need healing from the things we left behind. And when the bitterness inside us melts away somehow, we'll never have to think about it now. We'll never have to think about it now. We need healing. We all need healing from the things we left behind. And when the bitterness inside us melts away somehow, we'll never have to think about it now. We'll never have to think about it now. We'll never have to think about it now. All right, and that's healing. It's from the Blue Skies and the Rain CD, actually, if that's still around. Thank you, guys. Thank you.
All right, where do we go from here? All
right,
we can do Love Suffers Long.
Yeah, let's do Love Suffers Long. So once again, this is a story song, and I moved from New York, and I was working on Lower Broadway, 6th Avenue, Lower Broadway, in Manhattan. And I got a call from a record company that said that they wanted to fulfill a promise that they had made to me to record an independent project. So I moved out of this area, New York area, to Nashville, and I lived on West End, which is actually Upper Broadway. And so I just imagined what it would be like walking down Broadway. And one of the people I met when I was back in New York riding a subway inspired me about forgiveness. Another person I met online, early days of the internet, inspired me about my belligerence. And another person I met, listened and didn't meet, but heard on the radio, TV preacher, radio preacher, inspired me not to be so unkind in my language and my forcefulness in my presentation of God's love. Three stories, I hope you enjoy them. It tells you about what love truly is. I met a woman on the internet last night who tried to teach me all about astrology. It started friendly, but then it turned into a fight when I attacked her words with my theology. I hurt her feelings, so she clicked right out of sight. And now I feel that I owe an apology. 'Cause love, love is never unkind. It's gentle and meek. And love doesn't seek its own way, and love would never remind or keep an account of the wrong if love suffers long. I heard a preacher on the radio last week who shouted to a crowd about morality. And hatred in the words he chose to speak, and hate for those who don't believe like you and me. His voice was anything but patient, kind, and meek. Perhaps he just thinks that's not his personality. Love, love is never unkind. It's gentle and meek. And love doesn't seek its own way, and love would never remind or keep an account of the wrong, 'cause love suffers more. I ride the subway with a man who lost a limb, but wears a wooden leg as if he doesn't care. And one day he told me that someone did this to him, but he'd long since forgiven them in prayer. I told him I feel I've been amputated too. Somebody ripped my heart apart so long ago. I said, if I cannot forgive, well, how could you? He said, when your love suffers long, you'll know, you just know that love, love is never unkind. It's gentle and meek, and love doesn't seek its own way, and love would never remind or keep an account of the wrong. Love suffers long. Love is never unkind. It's gentle and meek. And love doesn't seek its own way. And love would never remind a sinner of all he's done wrong. Love suffers long. Love suffers long. Amen. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious, not rude, not belligerent, doesn't seek its own way, doesn't delight in evil, doesn't rejoice in truth. Love bears all things, hopes all things, believes all things. Love never fails.
Amen. Woo. All right, where are we going from here?
Any requests we need to be aware of?
Request.
We got a request, but we are going to continue to play anyway.
Okay, future, me. Okay,
we're going to play Future Me. Yep, we'll get to that.
Want to do Hold On?
Yeah, let's do Hold On. Why don't you talk about it?
Well, this song is a song that Raphael wrote, and he had it kind of tucked away somewhere, and then he took it out, and he said to me, "Hey, do you like this song? You want to sing it?" And I said, "Sure." And so I've been singing it ever since, but it's a great one.
Tells you a lot about the song, doesn't it?
Well, you wrote it. You should talk about it.
Important, guys, you got to keep hope alive. Our girls today went out in the driveway and they wrote a number of wonderful messages of inspiration, but the biggest one was this gigantic word, hope, the size of a car. And I posted that online because I really believe we cannot let hope die. We have to remain with hopeful anticipation of good things that God will do, and he hasn't forgotten us. He's got great things ahead. He's given us, according to Jeremiah 29:11, a future and what?
A hope.
A future and a hope. So even when things aren't good, even when things are super tough, he's our hope when hope seems like it's gone. This is You Are My Hope. You are my hope when hope is gone.
You are my hope when hope is gone.
You are the strength I lean upon.
You are the strength I lean upon.
You are the only light I see. You're my help in times of need.
And if I fall or if I fail,
if I fall or if I fail,
your endless mercy will prevail. And in the shadow of your wings, I have no fear of anything. And I'll forever see. You are my hope, you are my strength, you are my light, you are my help in times of need. You are my comfort and my joy. And if I should fall, if I should fail, I will find refuge in the shadow of your wings. You are my bright and morning star. You are my hope. If you know it, sing it with us wherever you are. We wrote this song a number of years ago and played it at a lot of worship services. You are my hope when hope is gone. You are the strength I lean upon. You are my hope when hope is gone.
You are my hope when hope is gone.
You are the strength I lean upon.
You are the light I see.
You are the only light I see. You're my help in times of need. And if I fall or if I fail,
if I fall or if I fail,
your endless mercy will prevail.
High in the shadow of your wings, I have no fear of anything. I'll forever sing. You are my hope, you are my strength, you are my light, you are my help in times of need. You are my comfort and my joy. And if I should fall, if I should fail, I will find refuge in the shadow of your wings. You are my bright and morning star. You are my hope, you are my strength, you are my light, you are my help in times of need. You are my comfort and my comfort and my joy. If I should fall or fail, shadow of your wings, you are my hope. You are my hope.
I should fail, I will refuge in the shadow of your wings.
Wow. Thank you very much. We're glad that you're here. Well, what do we need to tell you? I'm so glad that we're here. If you didn't know, we're at our house in Atlantic Highlands, and Abby and Phoebe are here manning the camera and monitoring the video and the computer. Behind us is darkness now, a little bit past sunset. It's a Shabbat night. That means it's Friday night, so we're having our rest, resting in the Lord, resting in His goodness. Behind us, about a half mile away, is the bay. 2 miles up the road is the ocean. So we're situated right on the north shore of New Jersey. And we're glad that you're here. If you need anything, just let us know. The bathroom's down the hall to the left or the right, depending on where you're at. All right.
We do have some more requests.
Okay, let's hear them.
Love suffers long. Time will tell. Time will tell. When we're gone, round and round.
Oh, round and round.
Let's take today. We have a lot.
Cool. Okay. Yeah. Round and Round. We did Love Supper Song, and we did a couple of those, but Round and Round I haven't done forever. You want to try it?
Sure. You want to, sure. You need words or no?
So,
sometimes you need words for your own
total
song.
Total disclosure. I wrote this song, it's at the point where I'm one of those old guys on a stool saying I wrote songs back in another millennium, literally. Deep into it, another part of history. I wrote this song, but it was a hit on Christian radio. It was a hit all over the country. It was with a label called Myrrh, and it was my first single. My first national single. I had a couple other songs cut and records released, but this one actually did something. And so I would go around the country and people were like, oh, I love your song. It was number one on our radio in Des Moines. And WJTL in Pennsylvania was number one there. And I guess, you know, I got a little taste of the charts. And it's hard to stay on the charts. Any Christian artist will tell you. But it's fun to have a song that people know. And so I was glad to have this song and to have a short career. I guess I still have a career. What am I talking about? So it's kind of a poppy song about, you know, God meeting us in our loneliness. And I don't really, people ask me, what is the whole concept of round and round? And I just don't really have a good explanation. It just sounded good.
You were young. We need some background singers, girls, so you know the chorus.
Looking out across the night, I still get lonely. Even though I know you're right here with me, still I'm in a constant fight to keep from sinning and from spinning. Round and round and round and round, I can see a world of gray, sadness and sorrow. I don't have the words to say, so I can't remember the words to say.
Silence.
Okay,
silence.
Let's start that again. I can see a world of gray, sadness and silence.
Silence.
And listen to this rhyme, beautiful rhyme. I don't have the words to say, so I turn to silence.
Silence, silence, silence.
Attitudes within my heart, they still need rearranging, but they're changing. Round and round, where can I run? My heart's undone, I need someone to hold me. You let me know, you love me so. You won't let go, you tell me. I know you'll stay with me forever. I know you'll stay with me forever. There's so many brand new things I have been learning. Finding out what's right and wrong, I've been discerning. And fire deep within my heart, it still keeps on burning and turning. Round and round, where can I run? My heart's undone, I need someone to hold me. You let me know, you love me so. You won't let go, you told me. Where can I run? My heart's undone, I need someone to hold me. You let me know, you love me so. You won't let go, you tell me. I know you'll stay with me forever. I know you'll stay with me forever. Brings back so many memories. I think about when I first heard the song come back. We sent it in as a demo. My brother Plinky did a great job producing it. But they gave it to a brilliant producer named Mark Hurd, who's gone, not with us anymore. Brilliant guy. And I didn't really like the first thing that he did with it. It was a do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. But people said that it was one of their favorite parts of the song. In fact, they turned it off when I started singing. They only wanted to listen to that.
That's not true. Where do we go from there?
We have Middle of My Heart.
Middle of My Heart.
Oh, yes. Star Shalom.
Star Shalom.
Rock Flowers Request.
Okay, some Rock Flowers. I think it's Allie's turn to sing. So Middle of My Heart, Star Shalom. We'll get to those for sure.
Okay. I think I did a couple Rock Flowers, right? Any particular Rock Flowers songs? No.
Just some rock songs.
Okay. Okay. All right. We'll have to think about that. In the meantime.
How about the frog one?
What?
The frog
one. Okay, so why don't we do, do you want to do maybe Light of the World or something?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so as I think about the old Rockflower songs, we'll do a new Aly song. Is this, can you get that or no? Do you need a chart?
Yeah. Okay. Six or five?
I think it's five.
Your choice.
Yeah, let's do five.
All right, so Aly recorded a lot of great songs with the Rockflowers, but my favorite album of Aly's is definitely her Able God CD, and so many good songs on it, especially this one. Just fantastic song that we sing around Christmas time. You know, if we're into the funny story mode, we were, what were we doing? We were learning a brand new song by Lauren Daigle called Light of the World for Christmas this past Christmas. And we're up in the office and we're learning it, going over the chords. And I got a text from someone that says, hey, Light of the World is being played on Gate Radio. George Forrest, you know, the wonderful Gate Radio. And I'm like, okay, well, we'll listen to it on that. And it was Aly's Light of the World on the radio. Lauren Daigle's Light of the World was being worked out.
Thanks, George, for supporting me. Unto us was born the Savior, unto us the King of Kings. His name was called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Here you are, true Messiah, bright morning star, rise. Resurrection and the light. Here you are, true Messiah, bright morning star, rising.
Oh, light of the world, shine in my darkness. Light of the world, Jesus.
Shine in my
cheering.
Woo!
You know, it's funny because our friends Lori and Carl Gentry, they do this as well. But I think they might even be doing it tonight. And he has like a little sample on his keyboard, which is a big stadium crowd after each one. That's what we need.
Yes, we need that. Aren't we good enough? You are.
You're great. All right, so someone said Middle of My Heart. So I'm up for the challenge. This was one of my favorite songs that was given to me that I wrote early on, my early walk. And it was really me just saying, God, I just want to be real with you. I know that you see me the way I am. You know what I do. You know all about me. And I want to talk to you face to face. I want to tell you what is in my heart. And so the lyric of it is, the chorus of it is, I want to know you. I want to see you. I want to touch you. No holds barred. I want to feel you, not just from the surface, not just from my mind and my peripheries, but the middle of my heart. That means your left atrium, right atrium, and aorta, right?
Left ventricle, right
ventricle. Okay, that's what I meant. Allie's
forgetting some parts.
All right. Face to face, from the middle of my heart, I want to talk to you. Just you and me, nothing to stand in our way. Eye to eye, from the middle of my heart, I want to see you. And for you to see me as I am, not my feeble display. Cause I'm dying just to be with you, and I'm crying cause I've run out of things to say. I want to know you, see you, touch you, no holds barred. I want to feel you from the middle of my heart. Hand to hand, from the middle of my heart, I want to touch you. Just one touch of your hand gives me chills to the bone. Arm in arm, from the middle of my heart, I want to walk with you. Through the dark, where I can't go on my own. Cause I'm dying just to be with you, and I'm crying, I can't stand being all alone. I want to know you, see you, and touch you, no holds barred. I want to feel you from the middle of my heart. Head to head, in the middle of my heart, I want to know you. Just like you are, not some preconceived image that I've seen. Glory to glory, from the middle of my heart, I want to grow in you. Whoa, heart to heart, I know you know what I mean. I'm relying on your faithfulness, and I am trying, but you've still got to intervene so I can know you, see you, and touch you. No holds barred, I want to feel you from the middle of my heart. I want to know you, I want to see you, touch you, no holds barred. I want to, I I just want to feel you from the middle of my heart. Thank you very much. That helps. Thank you. Thank you, guys.
That's all right. Good.
All right. So where do we go from here?
Wait, can you rattle off a couple more requests?
All right, when we're gone, Time will tell.
Okay. Great Star Shalom, I heard,
I'm scrolling.
Let's Take Today, I think. Can we try?
Yeah, let's do that one.
Let's take today. All right. There we go. So, Let's Take Today. So, let's talk a little about my guitar. How about that?
Sure, yeah.
I love this guitar. You know, I have very few precious possessions, and this is by far one of my most precious possessions. I'm not going to tell you about it because you're going to be tempted to come over here and steal it. But you can't find it. It's hidden and under lock and key. It's an Olsen. This is an Olsen guitar, and it belonged to, like I mentioned before, my hero and mentor, Phil Keggy. And he recorded many CDs and records and concerts with this guitar. When I lived next door to him, he had this guitar, and he let me play it from time to time. And this was custom made for him by the guitar maker, James Olsen. And as it started to get marked up a little, they asked for it back so they can send him a new one. And they sent him a new one. They switched it around, and he got a brand spanking new one. And he said, "You ought to play an Olsen, Ralph." I'm like, "Yeah, well, I can't afford an enormous amount of money. I can't afford it." "Well, let me see what I can do." He worked a deal somehow where he was able to get this back. And we put a little bit of money together that we had in the studio. And he said, brought it over. He says, "Here's your guitar, Raphael." So this is my life guitar. It's a beautiful cedar top. This Olsen guitar is very rare, but it's the only guitar that you'll ever hear James Taylor play. Anyway, it's the only guitars usually that you'll see Phil play, Leo Kottke, Paul McCartney has one, and I have one, and I'm going to play a song called Let's Take Today. It's a song for you to enjoy the moment, because you know what? Time passes quick, and you're doing exactly what you should do, and that's just take time to enjoy the things that you love to do with the people you love to do them with. This is called Let's Take Today. Time waits for no one, it just keeps on marching on. Tomorrow is here now, and yesterday is gone. The future's upon us, we can watch as it arrives. This is the first day of the best part of our lives. Let's take today and make it all it can be, and create another memory. Do all we can do, see all we can see, and remember every moment. Let's take today and make it all it can be, and create another memory. Live all we can live, be all we can be, and we'll never miss a moment. Take time and make time for what matters most to you, and don't be afraid to do all the things you love to do. Be in this moment now before it slips away, 'cause these are the good times we'll all talk about someday. Let's take today and make it all it can be, and create another memory. Do all we can do, see all we can see,
remember every moment. And let's take today and make it all it can be. And create another memory. Live all we can live, see all we can see. And we'll never miss a moment. Sands of time are falling fast, flowing through the hourglass. Days will come and days will pass. This is the way we can make them last. Let's take today and make it all it can be. And create another memory. Do all we can do, see all we can see. And remember every moment. And let's take today and make it all it can be. And create another memory. Live all we can live, be all we can be. And we'll never miss a moment. And we'll never miss a moment.
Okay.
Okay.
I'm glad you enjoyed that one.
Yay!
Oh, yeah!
Okay, good. Woo!
All right.
That was a close one.
How are you doing? Good.
Yeah, we're good.
Yes, it is
8:17. What time does this cafe close?
I think
stay closing time.
Are you ready for Blue Skies, or do you want to wait on?
Take a little break on Blue Skies for now.
Okay.
Blue Skies is a big production.
Okay, got it. Okay, so all right, let's take a look here. What have we not done? Take a look. Our master list.
Someone mentioned Sar Shalom, so we could do Sar Shalom. Why not? Sar Shalom is a sing-along, if you know it. If not, it's just a sing to at you. We sing at you. Sar Shalom is a good song for Shabbat, and it's a good song for this season, because it's a prayer, really. It's a prayer for God to give us his peace during a time where we absolutely need his voice. We need to hear his voice to be the only sound we hear in a time when the world is troubled. And this world is very troubled. So this goes out as both a prayer for you and a praise to God. It's called Sar Shalom. Sar Shalom, fill our hearts with comfort and the peace the world can't understand. Hold us close, like a loving father, with a child in his hand. Lead us home, to a place of quiet, though the world is overcome with fear. Above the sounds of tragedy and violence, only voice we hear. Sar Shalom, Prince of Peace, may your kingdom reign forever, bringing peace to the people of the earth. For you are our salvation, and the hope of every nation is in you. Songs of praise never cease. Change the world through your loving kindness.
kindness and the power of your peace. Tsar Shalom, Prince of Peace, may your kingdom reign forever, bringing peace to the people of the earth. For you are our salvation, and the hope of every nation will forever be the same. By the power of your name, Tsar Shalom, Prince of Peace, may your kingdom reign forever, bringing peace to the people of the earth. For you are our salvation, and the hope of every nation is in you. That's our prayer for you on this Shabbat, that the Prince of Peace, the Tsar Shalom, will give you peace tonight and carry into this new season, regardless of what you're facing. How about a little majesty?
Oh, can I do that?
Yeah. Majesty. Nice. Aly wrote a beautiful song for her last CD called Majesty, and it starts out with a strange verse from Psalms, I think it is, right?
Yes. I think it's Psalms. No, actually, I think it's like Job.
Yeah, it is. It's Job.
I think it's Job.
Job. Yep. And what is it?
It's, I think it's, as the sparks fly up, man is born to trouble. So I paraphrased it a little bit. Man born to trouble as the sparks fly above. All right, get that capo on there. To trouble as sparks fly above. The king laid his life down to show his great love. The ransom was paid through the grace of a glorious God. Love made a way in the midst of it all. Messiah delivered the price for the fall. All through the merciful hands of a glorious God. Majesty, rescue me. Jesus, victory. Led like a lamb into suffering and shame, the Father has highly exalted your name. Salvation has come through the love of a glorious God. But death and the grave had no hold over you. In victory, the stone rolled away from the tomb. Redemption redemption was won through the power of a glorious God. Majesty rescued me. Jesus victorious. Majesty set me free, my God is glorious, glorious. Oh, humbled by your love, leveled by your grace, you carry scars and shame, covered by the blood, stronger than the grave. All my sins are washed away. Majesty rescued me. Jesus victorious. Majesty set me free. My God is glorious. Your glory.
All right. Wow. Beautiful. We don't do that song enough. We got to do that song. We're so glad that you're here on Facebook. Some of you are on Raphael and Aly Facebook. Some of you are on the North Shore Fellowship Facebook. Some are on my Facebook. I'm sharing it. It's not on YouTube tonight because it's not a premiere. We do the premieres for church. That's Sunday morning. We're on YouTube and Facebook, but on Sunday night, on most of these live events, we're just on Facebook. Thanks for Facebook. Okay. All right. Some of our audience members are scurrying around. They must want an intermission. Any messages from the technical crew? Do you guys?
How good Aly sings.
Thank you so much.
Many.
Did anybody say how good I sing?
Yes,
no.
I'm sure.
Here it is. All are saying
she sings
that.
Better, but I can sing louder. You want to sing?
You are loud. You sing great.
How's your side of the technical booth? Okay, great.
How's our battery power? Do we have my? Well, no, you don't have to check. You can just leave.
All right, just don't touch that. That's Abby's. That's Abby's responsibility. You were in that part of the booth.
Okay.
Projection. Technology, cameras, computers.
All right. So where are we going? You want to do?
All right. So something came to mind. What are some of the songs that were requested that we didn't do? I don't want to leave those out, especially if we know them. What a waste that would be.
Let me scroll up.
Okay. How about Once Upon a Time?
Oh yeah, we can do that.
Let's do Once Upon a Time. Okay. So Once Upon a Time. This is actually our wedding song. And I wrote it for Ally's sister's wedding. And I sometimes say that it was a ploy to get Ally to do a duet with me when I was trying to get her to date me. Didn't work. She didn't want to date me. But the duet was nice, right?
Yeah.
And afterwards, after that gushy, romantic moment of singing this beautiful song together, I said, let's not just be friends. Let's make us an issue, an item. She said, let's just be friends. So I'm leaving.
Don't leave.
But, ooh, that's too loud. But anyway, it all worked out.
It did.
I wrote it for Trish and Tyler's wedding. But Michael W. Smith sang it to us for our wedding on the beach in Belmar, Jersey Shore.
Once upon a time, a young man was dreaming, smiling and scheming. Someone caught his eye. Once upon a time,
every now and then, a woman discovers a man like no other, and every now and then becomes once upon a time.
May your once upon a time be your happy ever after. May your hearts be filled with laughter
every day.
And as your lives begin to rhyme, may God give you all his best things, all the joy and all the blessings for always.
On this special day,
the world is excited,
your hearts are united, and love is here to stay. Let this be the day you'll find your once upon a time. May your once upon a time be your happy.
So we're going to have to find the lyrics for that. It's one of those songs I don't do all the time, but I should. All right, it's a song I wrote for our little girls. And they kept growing up on us. We wrote them when they were little baby girls. And I actually didn't play it for them until their fifth birthday. So I couldn't get through without tears. But this is for anyone that has a little girl in their life. It's called Let Me Hold You. Get that riff. I met a girl today I'd never seen before, but I held her in my hands as she was crying. I whispered in her ear and held her close a little more. Then she laid her head upon my chest and drifted off to sleep, and I said, let me hold you just a little bit longer before you go to sleep and end another day. 'Cause when you wake up, you'll be older and stronger, one step closer to walking away. Let me hold you a little bit longer today. Again,
with someone who's so sweet. She could melt your heart and make you feel just like a child again. Though she cannot walk or talk, sometimes still needs help to eat. I just love to sit and watch her as I gaze into her eyes and tell her, let me hold you just a little bit longer before you go to sleep and end another day. 'Cause when you wake up, you'll be older and stronger, one step closer to walking away. Let me hold you a little bit longer today. So let me hold you now while you still want to be held, and you like the silly songs I sing and stories that I tell. Let me hold you now as I pray you off to sleep, that your thoughts would all be pleasant and your dreams would all be sweet. I spent the afternoon with someone else's world, filled with crayons, books, and toys and games I still don't understand. Just another perfect moment with a special little girl. Then I picked her up and held her tight and whispered once again, baby, let me hold you just a little bit longer before you go to sleep and end another day. 'Cause when you wake up, you'll be older and stronger, one step closer to walking away. Let me hold you a little bit stronger today. Let me hold you a little bit longer today.
Sometimes.
Yeah, that's fine.
All right.
I think we're ready for Blue Skies.
Okay, how about a little Blue Skies?
Blue Skies.
All right, so this song actually has a whole story to it, which we'll skip tonight because we're running out of time, right?
No, let's say the story.
Okay,
I've got time. Who's got anywhere to go anyway?
It's one of the best parts.
All right. It also has weird sound effects.
Whoa!
With my wonderful box of magical music. I don't want that. So let's change that. There we go. Fixed it. So I was living in Nashville, Tennessee, as I said before, and I was living at the Country Music Hall of Fame Quality Inn Hotel, and it was anything but country, anything but quality, I should say. It was all country, country all the time, right on Music Row, right by the Country Music Hall of Fame. And I was recording the CD, Blue Skies in the Rain, so I was living there by myself and didn't have a whole lot of money, and we recorded in the off hours. So down on Music Row, some of the studios would sort of close overnight, but if you had a producer who had an inn, he could get you some studio time when the big, important country music stars were not using the studio. So I would get calls at 2 in the morning, 3 in the morning, come down, you know, let's lay down some tracks, vocals, guitars, whatever. So you almost had to always be on hold and on standby. And so I wasn't alone. I was living in the Country Music Hall of Fame hotel with a bunch of other people that were just like me. They were, you know, promising, hopeful, songwriters and country stars and music artists. I wasn't a country artist, but I was what I called a modern folk artist. Anyway, long story short, at the hotel there was a lot of guys from all over the region, but nobody was from New Jersey. See, I was the only Jersey guy, and I would be in, you know, practicing my New Jersey guitar riffs while I was waiting for a studio call. And you know what that's like when you live on the Jersey Shore. I grew up playing here on the Jersey Shore, cover bands, and so I'd be minding my own business, you know, doing my Jersey riffs, and I was starting to get some attention, and then some, you know, kind country gentleman, you know, guitar player comes along and says, son, you know, if you're going to be playing guitar here in Nashville, Tennessee, you ain't going to be playing music like that. It's going to be music sort of like this.
Yeehaw.
know what I'm getting at. But I tell you, I don't write music like that. I write deep songs, you know, like, you know, about my soul and about things that are going on. I'm not afraid to embrace my fear and my hurt and my sorrow, as you see in some of my songs. And I said, you know, that's not the kind of music that I want to be doing. But thank you anyway. I said, but there's got to be a music around here that works for me. Someone that really is in touch with their emotions and their pain. He says, well, there is music around here about that, but it ain't from Nashville. It's about 3 hours down I-40. Is it 40? Where the sun sets over the Mississippi on a street called Beale. And there's a lot of pain in the songs there. Country music, it's something else. What's it called?
The blues.
The blues.
Yeehaw!
But the blues wasn't made for guys like me either. You know, the blues was kind of depressing kind of music. And there's not supposed to be any hope or joy or happiness in blues. Otherwise, it's not blues. And it was built for guys that may be in touch with their sorrow, but they don't want to get out of it. They want to stay in it. And they write songs sort of like this. My dog died, and my wife left me. I'm sure gonna miss him. Dog. And I wasn't writing music like that either. I had hope. Yeah, I had pain, but I had hope that someday the clouds would roll back. And there'd be sunshine in my life again, once again. The Lord healed me and brought me joy. And even though it might be raining, I'd see blue skies in the rain. So when I wrote my first blues song, it wasn't a blues song at all. It was blue skies in the rain. It goes like this. An instrumental. No, I'm just kidding. I can tell you my whole story. Talk about all my hurts and scars. And then you could all feel sorry for me. That wouldn't change the way things are. Cause I've been stuck inside my sorrow. And it's taken all I've got just to cope. Now I have found hope for tomorrow. Now I have found a place of hope. I found blue sky in the rain. I found comfort, trying to get through this troubled land. I ain't the one doing the walking. There's one set of footprints in the sand. Yeah, you beach people know what I'm talking about. I ain't the one doing the walking. No. There's one set of footprints in the sand. I found blue sky in the rain. Chase. in the rain.
A lot of dancing going on in this house.
Well, that's not a way to treat an Olsen, but... All right, guys, that was fun.
And the crowd goes wild.
All right.
I think I'll pour myself a drink.
Water. Okay, so...
All right, so we could get into the other guitar if you want, or you want to... Oh, you know we need to do Able God.
Oh, really?
Able God.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you have enough battery power?
I'm sure we're okay.
All right.
We have Able God on YouTube, right?
Able God is the title cut of Ali's CD called Able God.
It is.
It's not really an Adam and Eve, Cain and Abel story called Abel's God. It is Able God. All right, so what's the name of it?
Right, guys.
Okay,
yeah. So I put out a CD a couple years ago, and I was writing songs after leading a lot of worship in church, and you know, you're always looking for that song that will fit into the set. And there was a couple times where I felt like, oh, I can't really find the song, and then I would pray and say, Lord, do you have any songs that you could give me? And so God was just downloading a bunch of songs to me during that time. And so I came up with about 10 songs for the project. And this is the title cut called Able God. And we've done it a lot of times in church. And so I'll sing it for you. Change. We were supposed to do.
I think it's 37, but we were doing 38.
I thought it was two. You thought it was one. It's okay.
We do have a request of the girl singing a song.
Oh.
You guys up for it?
Sure. What do you want to sing?
I don't know. Anything, I guess.
Do Your Love Is Reaching Me?
Yes, perfect.
What's that?
Your Love Is Reaching Me.
Your Love Is Reaching Me.
All right, let's do that one. Girls, come on over. So the girls sang on this recording, this song.
Also on the Able God CD.
Yeah. Able God, all day and all night. Go over. Let's go that way.
And
let me just find it first, and then you guys. Oh, there it is. Okay.
I can't see the words. And for this one, even though we say it,
here, Abby,
I actually do need the words for this one.
Okay. All right. Let's see if we can make this happen.
Amy and Abigail. and this is Facebook friends. So glad you're here.
Can you guys, I think, let's see if we can see you. We can't see Abby, so Abby's got to slide over a little. Abby, move over just a little bit toward Phoebe.
I am.
Okay, that's better. Okay, now everybody can see you. All right, perfect. Okay.
All right.
All right, you ready?
Yeah.
So it's. Your love can move any mountain, can plunge the deepest sea. Your love can reach to the heavens. Your love reaches me, finding me. Your love is faithful and mercy, a banner over me. Your love wider and deeper, your love reaches me, changing me. Your love can reach me anywhere, no matter where life leads me. You are there on mountaintops or on the far side of the sea. High up or in lonely places, your love reaches me, holding me. Your love can reach me anywhere, no matter where life leads me. You are there on mountaintops or on the far side of the sea. Your love is reaching me.
Phoebe and Abigail. All right. And they're our technical crew as well, so they're not just
that
beautiful.
That was why no one was commenting during that song.
Well, we do want your comments, guys, so why don't you take a moment to comment, tell us who you are, where you're coming in from, and we're going to get back to you a little later. Let me adjust my stool back again. And why don't, where are we at?
We're rounding up with two more songs.
Two more songs. So I want to switch guitars, tell you about the special guitar that I have that you've probably never seen. And we'll put the Olsen away for now. So this is a Corbin guitar built by my friend Bill McLaughlin, and a wonderful guitar maker. I mean, that's really not his main job, but he makes such beautiful guitars you would think that it was his main job. So we're going to play it on this. No, just need to pick up right back. And this is, he built this for me. It took him a long time, and he built this for me. He said he was listening to my music as he was building it. It's built out of acacia wood, which is what they built the Ark out of it. And so if you look on the inscription, it's called the Ark. That's the name of this guitar, built by Corbin Guitars. And really pleasure to play this. And wait till you hear the sound. So what I'm going to do is play a couple songs from my Blue Skies and the Rain CD, and these are open tuning. So this first one, I believe, will be that's an F sharp. It's like a high D open tuning with a D on the B string. Song that I wrote about a weird occurrence that may or may not have taken place. I'm walking down Lower Broadway and running into someone who is very, very strangely familiar. It's called Future Me. Strangest thing happened to me yesterday. Was walking along down on Lower Broadway when a stranger approached me mysteriously. A man in his 60s, but looked just like me. He said, "I've just arrived from 2032. So you're looking at me, you are looking at you. I don't know why I'm here or for how long I'll be. There's things I can tell you, so listen to me." And so I said, "Oh, talk to me, future me. Tell me the things that I'm longing to know. How will my life go?" I said, "Please, please speak to me, future me. You see the things that I'm longing to see. And how will my life go?" And he said that we both know this whole thing is strange. I can't say too much, cause our whole life would change. But I will tell you two things you may think are odd. Cherish your loved ones and stay close to God. Well, I said, "I cherish my loved ones, I'm close to God too. But there's so much more I want to know about you." And before I could get him to say anymore, he vanished and I was alone like before. Thank you.
noticed a young boy in front of the stage. He looked just like I did when I was his age. But before I could tell him the things I was told, he asked me how his life would be when he's old. And so he said, oh, talk to me, future me. Tell me the things that I'm longing to know. How will my life go? I said, please, please, listen to me, former me. Cherish your loved ones, stay close to God too, and love will come to you. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
That's part of the ending. All right, guys. Well, we appreciate you being here with us tonight, and it's been a pleasure to play music for you. I'll tell you what, it's been a good time for us. You know, sometimes when you have pandemics, it's good to just find some things to bide the time in a positive, encouraging way, and that's what we've been doing with you guys. We've had fun. And I do know that there's a lot of people that are suffering. And I know it's not even just COVID-19. We have had so many of our friends lose loved ones. And I'm talking about parents. I'm talking about children. I'm talking about brothers, sisters. And the sad part about it is that the funerals are not the same right now. And the grieving process is really contorted in a lot of ways. I see it in my friends. And that's sad. But the truth is this. Jesus said, I go to prepare a place for you, that where I go, you may also be. He said, no eye has seen. The Bible says, no eye has seen, no ear has heard, nor has it entered into the heart of man. That means you can't even imagine the great things that he's prepared for those who love him. And I believe that the hope of glory is true. We can trust and believe in it. And what that means is that those who call upon the Lord, those who believe in the name of the Lord Jesus and are his followers, they have a paradise that awaits them that we can't even fathom. We can't even comprehend how great it is. And so what we do is we imagine and we hope, but we will see face to face. Paul says in 1 Corinthians 13 that right now we only see a little bit. We only see in part, but then we shall see face to face. And so, friends, I hope that you know that Jesus meant business when he said to that thief on the cross, this day you'll be with me in paradise. And that's for all of us and our loved ones if we believe upon the Lord Jesus. So we're going to leave you with a song. And it's a song about that. A song all about heaven, what it's going to be like. And I think each of us can have a hope of glory, a hope of blessed assurance to know that Jesus waits for us and will be welcoming us into paradise when we are gone, when we're gone. When we're gone, we'll be in heaven, looking downward at the sky. We'll know all that there is to know, never have to ever wonder why. When we're gone from here forever, we'll say our last goodbye.
But we'll go to a place where joy is ever present. We'll never have to cry. We'll be brighter than a sunny afternoon. We'll be lighter than a helium balloon. We'll fly higher than the mountains on the moon. When we are gone, when we're gone from all the worry, from the anger and the stress, we'll be trading all our bitterness and fear for constant peace and happiness. Ah, yes, we're far away from these horizons, way beyond the furthest star. He has gone there to prepare a place, a paradise. Someday will be ours. Though I know the thought of dying makes us scared, no one wants to leave a life that they have shared. But nobody knows the things he has prepared for those who love him when we're gone. When we're gone, we'll be with Jesus, and we'll see him face to face. Yeah. We'll be gone from all the sorrow and from every form of pain. And in the twinkling of an eye, we'll all be changed, and we'll never be the same. Never again. We'll be lighter than a sunny afternoon. We'll be brighter than a helium balloon. We'll fly higher than the mountains on the moon. When we are gone, though I know the thought of dying makes us scared, no one wants to leave a life that they have shared. But nobody knows the things he has prepared for those who love him when we're gone. We'll be brighter than a sunny afternoon. We'll be lighter than a helium balloon. We'll fly higher than the mountains on the moon. When we are gone. So much for being with us. I'm Raphael, this is Aly, and we're so glad to spend some time with you this night. Thank you, girls, Abigail and Phoebe, for our technical crew, and for all of you who have joined us on Facebook and Facebook Live. So glad you're here. What a fantastic night. And remember, there is hope in Jesus. You only have to say your belief and commitment to him and make a special prayer of commitment. If you want to make that, reach out to us. We'd be glad to lead you in a prayer of commitment to the Lord Jesus tonight, even if you want. Also, we have church right here, 10:30, right here on Facebook, 10:30 every Sunday morning. And folks, stay safe, stay healthy. Remember that you are not alone. God is with you. God is near you. God is for you. God bless you. Have a fantastic night.